Hello friends, today we will have a look at who Lord Ganesha is. Ganesha is said to be one of the first gods to be worshipped before we start to do anything. Okay, and there is also a reference in the Vedas that nothing can be done without him, Lord Ganesha or Ganapathy. So we're not going to talk about the already known stuff like who is Ganesha, Gana, Lord of Ganas, and so on and so on. We will try to understand the real nature of Ganesha. Okay? So there are many stories and many Puranas which describes the way how Ganesha was born and so on. One particular version of that is that Lord Ganesha was made from Parvati's body. And Shiva came and he cut off Ganesha's head, or it could be Shiva or even Lord Shani. He stared at Lord Ganesha and Lord Ganesha's head fell off, and Lord Vishnu, he went and found an elephant's head, brought it, and they fixed the elephant's head on Lord Ganesha and made him alive again. So this is one story. Is it practical to fix an elephant's head on a human body? I don't think so. So if that is the case, does that mean that this story does not have any meaning? No. These people have written these stories long time back with a logic in mind. Okay, here what we are trying to do is we are trying to understand what that logic could be. Okay, it is just an attempt. Now, on the other hand, I also want to point out one other story, which is about Indra and Durvasa. Once Lord Indra was riding on his white elephant, which is called Airavata, and sage Durvasa offered him a garland, and Lord Indra put this garland on the elephant's head, and the elephant trampled that garland under its feet. And then the elephant went away and Indra ran away, and the story goes on. So there is a link, at least I believe that there is a link between the elephant head and this Ganesha story. In the story of Indra, in Tamil, Indiran or Indriyam, the senses of a human being are called Indriyam. Okay? And the one who controls the senses is Indra, is mind. So, literally talking about our physical body, we all have sense organs and senses, and mind is the one which controls the senses. So, Indra, I compare Indra to the mind. Someone, Durvasa, gave something, a gift to Indra, to the mind, but the mind has decided to use those gifts through the senses. So anything which we do with the help of the senses will not give us a long-term benefit. That is for sure. Okay, because the senses, they always look for temporary and immediate pleasures. So the story, the moral of the story goes as if some gifts were spoiled by Indra by spending or by utilizing those great gifts through the senses. Okay, so let's imagine someone was living like that and then he died. Now in this, before we go to the story of Ganesha, I'd like to point out that in Siddhanta texts, let's say in Tirumandiram, written by Tirumular, he talks about how a child is born. Okay, how during the pregnancy period, how a baby is formed inside, not medically or clinically, but he talks about the logic. Okay, what he says is that when a child is conceived, all the sense organs, yeah, senses, okay, senses, and they call it as tattvas, how all these tattvas are brought into the body of the child and assembled in such a way so that when the child comes out, it is one complete pack. Okay, so the point which I want to highlight here is, when someone dies, something goes away. The body for sure dies. Okay, when someone dies, the body is lost. The body goes to the earth. But something, one is Atman or the soul, goes. What about the karmas? Where are they stored? Okay, it should be somewhere. It is not destroyed. We all know in Hinduism, the karmas follow, yeah, someone again and again and again. So the soul, the karmas do not attach to the soul. Okay, the soul is very pristine, it's very pure. So, but these karmas should do something, yeah. So these things, the logic is, these things go into another body to experience life again based on the effects of the previous karma. So this is the logic. Okay. So now, in the story of Lord Ganesha, the logic which I think is, Ganesha or Lord Ganesha, Ganapathy, was formed from Mother Parvati. That means from the Mother Earth or from our mother, a child's body is formed first. Okay. And then the real nature of the child, which is the Atman. Atman is equal to Paramatman. Yeah. But the real nature of the child is somehow cut off because of previous karma. Instead of the real nature of the child, what is getting attached to the body is the previous karmas. Okay? The previous senses, or you can say whatever deeds which one has done in his past lives come and gets attached to him. And then this man lives in this world again to experience the karma. So now, literally, I'm trying to equate the one human being with Lord Ganesha. Could that be right? I still say this logic is correct, because if you look into the Puranas, what did Ganesha do? We have to take that into account. In Hinduism, there is a concept called Arishadvargas. And they talk about six enemies of the mind. Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Mada, Matsarya. Kamam, what is Kamam? Kama is lust. Krodha, anger. Lobha, greed. Moha, attachment. Mada is, it is not pride, but Mada is the concept which entering into our mind makes us mad, go crazy and so on. So that is called Mada. Matsarya is jealousy. So these are the six enemies of our mind. Along with these six enemies, we also have Ahamkara and Mamakara. Ahamkara is the sense of I, okay? The I-ness in each individual. Mamakara is the sense of minus, my house, my car. Okay. So these 6 + 2 = 8. 8 impurities make one feel as if he is different from the Shiva, from Shiva. This is how the difference. So, in other words, the difference between Jiva and Shiva is this list of 8 elements. Okay. So, if we get rid of all these 8, then we will realize Jiva and Shiva are one. So, the logic of Ganesha is to represent that this human body contains these 8 impurities. And we have to get rid of them one by one. So if you look at the incarnations of Lord Ganesha, the first one is Vakratunda. Do you know the Asura which he fought with and killed? Matsasura. Yeah? Matsarya. I said earlier, right? Jealousy. So that was killed by Vakratunda. Ekatanda, second incarnation. Madhasura. Madhasura. Mahodara, third one. Moha Asura, he killed Moham. Gajanana, Loba Asura, greed. Lambodara, he killed Krodha Asura, yeah, Krodha. Vikada, he killed Kama Asura, Kamam. Vignaraja, he killed Mama Asura. Dumravarna, he killed Ahamkara Asura. Ahamkara is the last I-ness. I within this body, limited to this body, the feeling of that. So, if you look very closely, Ganesha, Lord Ganesha, killed all these Asuras which are inside the body. Okay? And Ganesha is representing literally the human body, and that's the reason why he's having a big belly pot, just to say that the body lives on the food. If you don't feed any food to the body will collapse. Okay, so that's the reason why Ganesha is always depicted as someone sitting in front of large amounts of food and so on. And this is also the reason why they make Ganesha in clay, yeah, big statues for Ganesh Chaturthi, and then take him on a procession and then immerse him in water. Just like how a human being, how we all live, when we are living, we just go around like a procession, and then when our time is up, we will be taken by Mother Earth in one way or the other. Okay, dissolved in water or burnt in ashes or put under the grave. Regardless of whatever it is, the body will be a part of Mother Earth again. Okay, just to show the cycle, our saints and sages of the past, they have formed a character called as Ganesha. Thank you.